Hi guys, don't forget to click on the subscribe button.
Hi guys, I'm Raging DJ and I'm here to present to you Apollo Global Capital follow-on offering made easy. So because of the popular demand based on my video on AC Energy FOO, so I made a FOO video for APL or Apollo Global Capital. So disclaimer guys, all information came from the official APL disclosures from PSE Edge and their official website. I am not affiliated with Apollo Global Incorporated. And guys, so gusto ko lang sabihin sa inyo what would you expect on this video. So first on the list, explain ko muna sa inyo what is FOO. Number 2, I'll explain on the chronological events since October 2020 up to February 2021 kung ano yung maging disclosures ng APL na possibly na maka-affect sa price movement niya. And lastly, on the last part of this video, I will present to you the possible strategy video given the possible price of APL's FOO price na sinabi din nila sa disclosures nila. So first guys, let me explain to you what is FOO or follow-on offering. So meron tayong dalawang important terms here. We have here the IPO and the FOO. So the difference between these two is the timing kung kailan sila i-offer sa public. So IPO or initial public offering is the first time a company offers its stocks to the public. So ang pinaka-common dito is the Merrymark IPO offered last year. So next, we have the FOO or the follow-on offering. It is usually done after the IPO or a publicly listed company, meaning yung itong company na to natitrade na natin sa stock market. So it has two types, the diluted as well as the undiluted. Pag diluted, new shares of the company are lower than its earnings per share, and undiluted, a tender involving additional shares of the company. So the price of FOO is derived from the market. Any investment financial firm working on the follow-on offering does not naturally concentrate on valuation but on marketing efforts. So a small discount is often offered alongside the price of the offering, which is derived from the closing price of the market on the transaction day. So in terms of the FOO guys, again we have dilutive and non-dilutive. So pag dilutive guys, it aims to raise more funds in the public market. More shares are being issued by the company, but its value is sustained. So the offer size increases and the per share earnings decrease. The proceeds of the subsequent stock offering are normally utilized to change the capital structure of a firm or pay borrowings. So for the non-dilutive follow-on offering, these are usually current shares kept privately by the boards of directors or founders which are sold to the public. The proceeds of the subsequent stock offering are accumulated by the share seller and not to the firm. So the earnings per share of the company is also unchanged since there is no issuance of new shares. So in my subsequent slides guys, papakita ko sa inyo kung ito bang APL FOO is dilutive or non-dilutive and the possible repercussions nito. And as well as in the upcoming slides, papakita ko sa inyo kung magkano ba yung sinabi nilang price before and ano yung pwede nating strategy na gawin. So this guys, so in beginning this slide guys onwards, I will be showing to you yung mga chronological event na nangyari kay APL since October last year until February 2021. So October 2, 2020 pa lang guys, hindi natin napansin, when the company had its authorized stockholders meeting, lumabas dito sa result ng meeting na yun is that the approval of conduct of a follow-on offering of APL's primary shares with authority delegated to the board of directors in relation to the finalization of the detail thereof. So October 2, 2020 pa lang guys, na-approve na yung FOO ni APL. So again, furthermore, in this meeting, October 2, 2020, nasabi na nila kung magkano yung price ng FOO, pati yung additional shares na i-add nila sa company. So during the subsequent meeting of the board of directors on October 2, 2020, the board approved the offer and sale of up to total of 12.3 billion common shares of APL at an offer price of 0.08 pesos with a par value of 0.01 pesos per share subject to the registration requirements of the SEC and the listing requirements of PSE. So October 2, 2020 pa lang guys, nagsabi na sila ng possible price ng kanilang FOO which is 0.08 pesos. And yung amount ng share na i-offer na, these are new shares guys, so 12.3 billion. So if a company adds additional shares from its existing market capital or its current outstanding shares, ang tawag doon guys is dilutive follow-on offering. So it would have effect on the total price of the company Pero kung yung i-add nilang shares is mas maliit lang compared sa outstanding shares, napaka-negligible lang ng effect niya, guys. So, papakita ko sa next slides ko yung computation ng possible price and mga possible na mga magiging movement ni APL. So, on October 5, 2020, the DBP approves the credit line of APL Incorporated subsidiary. So, dito guys, nakakuha na nila yung credit line nila from Development Bank of the Philippines. So, approximately $8 million ang kanilang hiniram sa DBP. On December 10, 2020, so, nagkaroon na naman sila ng disclosure. So, kinonfirm lang ni APL yung mga balitang lumalabas. So, according to the news, the firm mentioned the bright outlook for this undertaking as iron prices are hitting a 7-year high mainly because of the rising iron demand in China. Then, sinabi din nila na yung kanilang iron reserve is around 512 million metric tons and it would last up to 47 years. So, kaya malakas yung mga balita and yung demand for the traders to have this stock as well as trade because all-time high pati napakataas ng demand ng iron ore sa China as well as other Asian countries. So, this guys, I'll be showing you yung mga approval na nakuha nila para pakita ko sa inyo na approved na sila from DNR. They have the certificates. Ito din, they have already the comprehensive report on the result of the exploration. They also have this mineral resource validation report. So, yung mga pinakita kong certificates and reports, you can go to their website in order to read kung gusto nyo basahin. So, mahaba yun guys. So, ilang pages din yung mga documents na yun. So, on February 1, 2021, they had another disclosure. So, the mining operations are expected to start by mid or end February. So, malapit na guys. So, mid-February na ngayon. Halos palapit na tayo. As well as end February. So, the first vessel has arrived and 3 more vessels are expected to arrive within this year 2021. And furthermore, kinonfirm ulit nila na greenlight sila ng DBP ng $8 million credit line. So this, ito na guys. So February 2, 2021, Apollo Global Incorporated is pleased to announce that its subsidiary, the JDVC Resource Corporated, is ready to commence production of magnetite iron ore this February 2021. So dumating na guys yung pinakaunang mining vessel nila, which is the MB Siphon 1. A brand new deep sea mining vessel is now deployed at the sea waters of Cagayan. So, on February 8, 2021 guys, ito yung pinaka-latest disclosure nila. So, they clarified news report na sinabi sa balita is that the APL or Apollo Global prepares for a follow-on offering. This was posted in Philippine Daily Inquirer on February 8, 2021. So, according to the news, that the APL is planning to raise as much price of billion pesos through a follow-on offering this month to fund this latest offshore mining project. So, ang mahalaga dito guys, makikita natin is that Apollo Global Capital Incorporated confirms the information quoted above. So, totoo magkakaroon na ng follow-on offering si APL. So, nasabi ko na din kanina, no, October 2, 2020, based on their capital holders meeting, sinabi nila kung magkano yung possible price and kung ilan yung additional shares na i-add nila. And given that guys, so dito guys, so dito yung importanting another value na importance sa disclosure nito is that the company, a subsidiary of JDVC Resource Corporation, filed with the SEC a prospectus for the offering equivalent to 988 million pesos. So this is now awaiting the approval of the SEC. So tandaan nyo guys, 988 million pesos ang gusto nilang i-generate from this FOO. So ano ba yung pwede natin makuha ng information dito? So, ito guys, balikan natin. October 2, 2020, sinabi nila they would offer 12.3 billion common shares at a price of 0.08 pesos. So, kanina, February 8, 2021, sinabi nila they would generate 988 million pesos. Tapos, October 2, 2020, sinabi nila mag-degenerate sila ng 12.3 billion shares at a price of 0.08 pesos. So, let's just connect the dots, guys. So, dito guys, this is the latest chart of APL and it ended this price at 0.2130. So, it ended this price at 0.2130 February 8, 2021. So, ito na yung sinasabi ko guys. So, the APL FOO price possibly 0.08 pesos based on their disclosures dated October 2, 2020. So, paano natin makakonnect ng dot pati masusupport itong price na to? So, yan guys. So, sinabi nila kanina this day February 8, 2021. Yung balita, sinabi they would try to generate an offering equivalent of up to 988 million pesos. So remember, 988 million pesos, February 8, 2021. So balikan natin, October 2, 2020, 12.3 billion common shares at a price of 0.08 pesos. So basic lang guys, i-multiply natin 12.3 billion times 0.08 equals 988 million pesos. So makikita nyo guys, yung sinabi nila sa balita na February 8, 2021, nagtugma sa sinabi nila noong October 2, 2020. So possibly guys, ang price nga ng FOO is around 0.08 pesos, but we need to wait for their latest disclosures guys. So I'm just making my strategy video based on their disclosures. So hindi ako nag-invento ng price dito guys. So you can check out PSE Edge kung ayaw nyo, kung hindi kayo naniniwala na 0.08 pesos ang sinabi nila. So based on those guys, magagawin tayo ngayon ng mga assumptions kung paano natin pwede i-trade to si APL. So it's important to remember guys in my subsequent slides na magko-compute tayo ng possible price niya after the dilution. So take note guys that the outstanding shares of APL now is around 280 billion shares. Okay, 280 billion shares. At last traded price na is 0.213 pesos. So given this data, so we would add it in the TERP calculator. So the current number of shares, sinabi ko 280 billion shares. Tapos ang current market price na ngayong araw February 8, 2021 is 0.213 pesos. So next data guys, so sinabi ko kanina, they will be adding 12.3 billion shares at the price of 0.08 pesos. So i-add natin sa calculator yan. So number of additional shares issued is around 12.3 billion shares. Itong rights issue price is around 0.08 pesos. So ano mangyayari pag kinalculate natin? Ang magiging theoretical ex-rights price is around 0.21 pesos. So makikita nyo guys, example, in-apply ni APL ang FOO niya at the price of 0.213, ang magiging price na after the dilution is 0.21 pesos. Napaka-negligible lang na effect guys because makikita nyo na outstanding shares is 280 billion shares. At ang i-add lang niyang additional shares is around 12.3 billion. So napaka-konti lang na i-add niyang FOO. Kaya napaka-konti lang ng change siya price ni APL after the dilution. So sa mga nagsasabi na natatakot na baka malaking ang bagsak after the dilution, so think twice guys kasi ito na yung actual na calculation na pwede nating makuha. So thus, if APL's last price before the addition of the FOO shares is 0.213 pesos, then the diluted price will be 0.21 pesos. So that's based on my example, if ever lang na ngayong araw ginawa ang addition ng FOO shares ni APL. So next guys, so guys, again, this is would be the chart of APL on February 8, 2021. 0.2130 pesos ang kanyang price na nag-close ngayong araw. So we have here the first scenario. Sinabi nga kanina, if the tama nga sinabi nila nung October 2, 2020 that the FOO price is 0.08 pesos, then mag-peg tayo guys. So magsabi tayo, if ever the price before the listing date umabot siya na 0.45 pesos. So ano yung magiging price during the listing date or yung magiging diluted price niya? Okay? So theoretical lang to guys. So magbigay tayo ng first scenario. Kunyari, pinump nila yung price na 0.45 pesos. Tapos sinabi nila na kung kailan nila i-offer yung FOO nila. So magiging price after the dilution will be 0.43 pesos. Okay? So this is the first scenario. If ever na mag 0.45 pesos ang kanilang price before the addition of the FOO, ang magiging diluted price will be 0.43 pesos. So next, we go to the worst case scenario. Ayan guys, so now let's go to the second scenario. So now we peg on the worst case scenario. So kunyari nga na FOO price is proven to be 0.08 pesos based on their disclosures. Tapos ang price before the listing date, kunyari bumagsak pa yung price na from 0.2130 ngayon, tapos umabot na 0.15 pesos in the upcoming days bago nila sabihin kung kailan yung FOO nila. So magkano yung magiging price ni APL during the listing date kung kailan mangyari yung dilution. So yan guys, so 0.15 pesos ang magiging price na before the listing date, ang magiging diluted price na is around 0.15 pesos pa rin pag in-apply natin sa calculator. Again guys, bakit ang konti ng change ng prices niya, whether na i-pump up yung price or bumagsak? Because ang a-add ng nilang FOO shares is around 12.3 billion shares compared sa outstanding shares ng company which is around 280 billion shares. So yung 280 billion shares na yan guys, makikita nyo yan sa PSE Edge at pinakita ko din sa previous slides ko yan. So yan guys, so hope you learned a lot from this APL's FOO possible strategy video. And I would like to say that all of my information came from their official website as well as PSE Edge. So thank you guys for listening. Don't forget to click on the subscribe button.
Hi guys, don't forget to click on the subscribe button.